If you can't run with the big dogs, stay on the porch. If you've never heard this slogan before, then you're probably not a big dog. But all jokes aside, this silly slogan, among many others, played a key role in helping Big Dog Sportswear achieve massive success. Catchphrases like, "Do I look like a freaking people person?" and "Do I look like I skip a meal?" were crucial to Big Dog leading the casual wear movement of the 90s. Their products had a level of attitude and sarcasm that was hard to ignore. For example, did you know that you can't fix stupid? Not even with duct tape. Throughout the 1990s, Big Dog grew a sportswear empire around the ethos of attitude and fun, building a multi-million dollar business around one really big dog. At their peak, Big Dog owned and operated 215 stores spread all throughout the United States. But in the early 2000s, the brand experienced the beginning of a long, slow decline, closing one store after another as their sales began to dip. And today, in 2021, just one single Big Dog store remains standing, in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. So how did Big Dog go from a popular, nationally loved brand that was seemingly inescapable at one point to almost non-existent? Today, we're going to take a look at the history of Big Dog, their rise throughout the 90s, and their immense decline through the 2000s and 2010s. The story of Big Dog begins all the way back in the early 1970s, with two lifelong friends starting an outdoor gear company. After returning home from their service in Vietnam, soon-to-be entrepreneurs Richard Kelty and Rick Scott had absolutely no idea what to do with their time. However, they soon noticed that a handful of local stores were having a tough time sourcing sleeping pads. So, since they had nothing else going on at the time, Kelty and Scott saw this as an opportunity to make some connections and extra money. So they promised a local store they'd fulfill an order for 1,000 sleeping pads. And just like that, their first company, Sierra West, was born. The company that would eventually become Big Dog. But Kelty and Scott had a problem. Neither of them knew how to make sleeping pads. So they promptly got to work teaching themselves how to sew. And after lots of trial and error, they created 1,000 sleeping pads for the local store. And after their first year of business, Sierra West did over 20,000 in sales. But this was just the beginning for them. As sales continued to rise, Scott and Kelty moved the company to Santa Barbara, California. Here, they took a gamble on a breathable, waterproof fabric called Gore-Tex, a fabric used by many brands today. But at the time, it was brand new, and Sierra West was the first manufacturer to wholesale Gore-Tex products. So it came as no surprise when their Gore-Tex jackets took off and sold extremely well. But it wasn't until a person named Gib Mann joined the company that the Big Dog began showing up. So the story behind how they got their name Big Dog goes like this. In 1983, they were all out on a river rafting trip in Colorado when Gib Mann busted out a pair of shorts he and designer Joy Moran created. But instead of just regular shorts, they created giant, oversized, brightly colored shorts, which everyone instantly loved. A person on the trip saw the shorts and said, "Man, these puppies are big." This rafting trip among friends became the primary inspiration for the entire Big Dog brand. Promptly after this trip, Gib Mann grabbed a book filled with pictures of real-life dogs, did a couple different tracings until he got a drawing he was happy with, printed the image on a pair of shorts, and thus, the rule of the Big Dog began. After the unexpected success of their big puppy shorts, they followed this up with t-shirts, sweatshirts, stuffed animals, and more. But despite Big Dog's success in the retail apparel space, they were still having some financial troubles due to parent company Sierra West's declining profits. So in 1989, Kelty and Scott ended their partnership. Scott ended up staying with Big Dog while Kelty spent the next 10 years in the sunglass business. The financial strain from Sierra West going under proved to be too much, and in 1990, Big Dog had to file for bankruptcy, which was a big move, just not the good kind. But it wasn't all bad, because in 1992, two investors named Andrew Feshbach and Fred Kane came out of nowhere and purchased Big Dog for $10 million. Andrew and Fred were highly skilled at buying bankrupt brands and breathing new life into them, and they saw a lot of potential and room for growth in Big Dog. So they hit the ground running and began developing Big Dog into the brand as you probably remember it. And if this wouldn't have happened, Big Dog most likely wouldn't be around today. When they were acquired in 1992, Big Dog had a total of 5 stores, and sales were about $11.4 million. But under the guidance of their new management, this number skyrocketed in a matter of years, and there were many reasons for this. They split the company up into multiple divisions, and they did this because this helped them focus on what they were good at and what was working, which at the time was their retail division. So they doubled down on that and threw the best resources they could at it. They heavily pushed Big Dog into the best commercial space at the time, outlet malls, which sounds kind of funny now due to how much outlet malls have declined in the last decade or so, but having Big Dog in every outlet mall in the 90s was the main reason the Big Dog got so big. During a time when consumers became fed up with the limited, expensive options at department stores, Big Dog reigned supreme, and sales boomed. It's also been noted that outlet malls were the hottest distribution channel of the 90s, and this new shopping experience that was outlet malls allowed non-traditional, loud, and opinionated brands like Big Dog take off. And by 1997, Big Dog was head and shoulders above where they were just 5 years ago when they filed for bankruptcy. And from 1992 to 1997, they took their sales from $11.4 million to $68.7 million. But profits would only continue to grow as they went public that same year. And almost as soon as they did, Big Dog's IPO garnered $39.2 million, which they used to pay off any outstanding debts and were able to expand from 5 stores to 134 stores, with an ambitious goal to open one new store every month. And at this point, they'd also become relevant in popular culture due to celebrities like Arnold Schwarzenegger and NFL player Reggie White wearing their clothing. So this was a fruitful time for Big Dog, not just financially, but in terms of social proof as well. And according to an article by Ranker, anyone who was in grade school during the 1990s, there were big puppies as far as the eye could see. Thousands of young Americans did their time in the principal's office for their provocative shirts. Many a mother was appalled by her child's new sartorial acquisition, and grilling dads across the nation were cooking with the Big Dogs. But in 1999, they grew even bigger as Big Dog began licensing out their name to make products other than clothing. They believed licensing was a great way to leverage the brand without adding significant expenses to their budget. Through licensing, they collaborated with companies like Coca-Cola, Yamaha Motors, Kellogg's, Toyota, and many more. But their biggest opportunity by far was working with PetSmart. They worked out a deal where PetSmart would promote Big Dog on their website and offline advertising, while Big Dog promoted PetSmart in their physical stores and catalogs. And by this point, Big Dog was far more than just funny catchphrases and graphics. It became an entire way of life for many people. Being big, loud, opinionated, and taking up as much space as possible became an attractive way to live for countless people. For example, by 2001, the Big Dog Club was 30,000 plus members strong. And what was the Big Dog Club? It was a club for people who enjoy pets, leisure, sports, and of course, big dogs. Members received a special ID card, a newsletter, and discounts on Big Dog products. In that same year, in 2001, the brand peaked at 215 stores, with profits sitting at over $115 million. So how and why did things go so wrong? With that many stores and sales, you'd think they'd continue to grow and dominate forever. But that's far from the case, because by the mid-2000s, the decline had already begun. And it wasn't all Big Dog's fault either. Not to say they didn't play a part in their own demise, but due to consumer preference changing and the free market, people began gravitating more towards strip malls with large retailers as opposed to shopping at outlet malls, like in the 90s. And with Big Dog operating 215 stores across the US, this shift in the market hurt them in a huge way. But unfortunately, things would only get worse as e-commerce and online shopping took off. People had less and less reason to go to a physical store, and when they did, they rarely went to an outlet store. On top of this, stores like Spencer's and Hot Topic were in the process of cornering the novelty shirt market in strip malls. And to make matters worse, as the 2000s ended and we entered the 2010s, people had mostly gotten tired of shirts with loud graphics and daddish, bro humor type slogans, which has also played a huge part in Big Dog's decline throughout the 2010s. But oddly enough, Big Dog's devotion to not changing their brand aim or image has actually helped them gain a bit of a cult following, mainly among two crowds. People who wear the shirts ironically, but mostly among big, probably angry, masculine dads who almost certainly wear the brand unironically, while cracking a cold one next to their American flag. Another reason Big Dog hasn't completely dissolved in modern times is because they do a great job of keeping their graphics and content time relevant by making parody shirts of topics relevant in pop culture. For example, during the last election, they made a shirt that said, "Do these paws look small?" But even with this working in their favor, in this new decade, Big Dog is a far cry from what they once were. Today, in 2021, Big Dog does almost all of their business online, along with their last remaining store in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. In just 20 years, they went from a thriving brand with 215 physical stores to just one, and a web store. It's wild to think that not that long ago, relatively speaking, they were a huge nationally recognized brand raking in millions from their slew of stores. And now, seeing a Big Dog shirt at the thrift store or seeing them mentioned online almost feels like looking at a fossil. And I'm curious, what do you think about this? Do you think Big Dog will ever regain the popularity it once had, or will they last as long as they can before fizzling out? Let me know down in the comments below, because I asked a bunch of my friends about Big Dog when I was making this video, and pretty much everyone was like, "Dude, I've like never heard of that brand before and don't remember them." So please tell me I'm not insane and that someone else remembers this brand. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next Thursday.